Everything is for sale. Everything is for sale. Because, I mean, I thought of that. I was thinking of that. I was like, not that original, but I was thinking of that because of a certain nation that has been causing havoc on the earth. And maybe even the key of the 9/11 dilemma, where the United States becomes an extension of the Intifada. And their famous quote is, "Everything is negotiable." So who is that? Well, I could classify it as the majority of human nature in the history of the entire human race. Because that's what they always say. They finally get too smart. Certain guys get too smart for their own good, and they say stuff like that. So I'm telling you, hey, I'm taking it a little further. I'm saying everything is for sale. Look, I got the hat on. I got my hat, don't I? Huh? I got the beard. I can say it already. Everything is for sale, schmuck. Huh? Well, that's capitalism. All caps. That's how I wrote the title. All caps. You know, that means in hyperbole of the internet, you're really mad. Yes, I am mad. I'm mad. Huh? I'm outraged. I would be doing this if I wasn't so outraged. That's capitalism, buddy. All caps. That's how you get taken over by empires. You wonder, oh, how come we have to bear these heavy burdens? Well, because somebody out there in human nature thought they would pretend to negotiate. And they abused their capitalism. And all you got left is all caps. Now, people have bought and sold since day one. But as an ism, quote unquote ism, and most isms, by the way, are religions, capitalism goes back several centuries. It's one of the ancient religions, the worship of money, right? Huh? It just became capitalism over the last several centuries. There's a quote on the wall of the Jefferson Memorial in Washington, D.C. Something about a kid, making a kid wear trousers that no longer fit him. You know, get it? Economic stability is contingent on price stability. Now we're starting to get into the secrets. You guys should have known this. The key to true prosperity is that all prices never change and the value of the money never changes. And if it does, you find out who did it and you got the enforcement agency to jump all over them. Take away their license to do business. It's that serious. When they do change, and I'm not saying if, because it always is human nature, it severely limits an individual's, I mean, use your common sense, it severely limits an individual's ability to plan what he or she can do in an economic system. After a while, nobody can see straight. And things get so confusing that the establishment suffers periodic breakdowns. Now that's common. Anybody can figure that out. In a system of static prices, people can become tremendously wealthy by such things as, instead of charging more money for something, such things as add to the inventory. The basic prices help to establish the value of other items. The merchant provides more costly items. The same applies for services. I know that the communists of the 20th century tried price control, but they had problems. They had problems with corruption. Interest rates and prime lending rates don't control inflation. Instead, enforced systems of fair values is overseen by an enforcement agency, much like the Department of Weights and Measures. That's why the gold standard was so competent. The mystique of gold was that it had a fairly constant and reliable value. So here we have, like, this is what? This is like, okay, 2011, what? The 21st century, huh? Okay, I tell you what an ounce of gold is. $32 is too much for an ounce of gold. It should be $32, not more. It should be a lot less. But for my amount of reckoning and things, ballpark 32, just for openers. What is it now? Over $1,000 per ounce? No, it isn't. It's 32. The inflation makes it look like $1,000 or more. And I think that's a lawnmower, and your assets are grass.